Yeah, really thanks. So today, in this particular session, we will go on for tuning of controllers. Well, in the previous lecture, I have told you something about how process control could be taken into consideration, and it was an intro. In process control, now it's about a very interesting topic, controller tuning. What is controller tuning? As a human being, we have our brain as a supreme controlling element which could decide our activities. Similarly, for any mechanism, especially a closed loop system, controller plays a very crucial role. This controller, if you look at the basic block diagram of any generalized system, the basic block diagram of any generalized system would be, there is a system which would have an output variable, it has a feedback, it goes on to an error reduction, which goes on to give its input to a controller, which gives this decision or the manipulated variable to a final controller element. That way it is reflected back onto the system. The important part of the controller is it gets an input as error, where this error is nothing but the difference between R and C, where R is the reference input and C is the current input. Now what is it we are looking for is, with this input or error, how the controller is taking a decision so as to calculate something called as a manipulated variable. This controller has an algorithm. As our current technology is concerned, the algorithms are humpty in number. We can talk about a neural network, a fuzzy logic. We can talk about genetic algorithm incorporated. There are so many, but irrespective of whatever is the operation technology, the most fundamental and basic aspect of the controller is a proportional integral derivative controller, which I can call it in the most simplest of form as a PID controller. Okay, how this PID controller works? Does it need a platform for implementation? It is an algorithm. The algorithm depicts the relationship between the manipulated variable to the error. This algorithm can be incorporated for a pneumatic system. It can be incorporated for an electronic system. It can be incorporated in a microprocessor-based control. It can be incorporated in a personal computer. If it is a single loop controller, it can be incorporated in a distributed control system. It can be incorporated in a programmable logic controller, and any format or platform is applicable. Next, how? What is this algorithm? Is it so powerful? From when is it existing? This controller is existing almost from the late 1940s, that is when the industrial revolution was generated, and later it founded by, it was just taken into account through very famous personalities like Ziegler-Nichols. Ziegler-Nichols were the pioneers in tuning a controller. My dear friends, I can even say that there are more than 1000 methods of tuning a controller, of which Ziegler-Nichols, Kohlen, Kuhn are very, very famous methods, some of the very famous methods. We'll even take Ziegler-Nichols into consideration. That's one important method, and from the very famous book, Automatic Process Control by Donald R. Kaufner, it has having a significant and a beautifully described quotient. When you're free, you can just refer to that also. That's a fantastic version. Now, go to the controller. What's a controller going to do? The controller is nothing but an algorithm. In reality, it could be a pneumatic or any other systems. Well, fine. Now, getting deeper into the algorithm. It is all about this value, manipulated variable proportional to error. If this is the concentration, I would be calling this as a proportional controller. This proportional controller would be confronting with an equation called as M is equal to Kp into E, where Kp will be called as the proportionality error constant. To tell the significance in detail in the regular aspects, I can tell more of the mathematical derivations, where mathematically itself we can prove the characteristics of the system currently impressed upon me. For this, if you try to plot the characteristics of time versus the variable of the system y, and this is going to be having a set point, let me say, with unity, where 0 and 1, 0 represents the previous steady state condition, 1 represents the required steady state condition. So in this particular manner, if I am implementing a proportional controller, the response curve would be like this. It will be still a first order system only, and there will be a definite offset. This is the characteristics. Suppose the controller is going to be having a situation of what's it going to be called as this Kp value as a very low one. The system would be very stable, the offset would be very high. If the controller is going to be having a very high value, offset will be reduced, but the system will be having fluctuating responses. This is another aspect. Now, quickly going on to the next stage of controller, which is how is that I can eliminate the limitation of this controller. The limitation of this controller is the offset. That offset, if it needs to be eliminated, then I will use as M is proportional to error plus integral of this error. I will try to consider the area under the curve, and area under the curve will be looking for to take appropriate decisions. Technically speaking, this will be M will be made as equal to KPE plus KP divided by PI integral of E dt plus C. Well, Kp is a proportionality constant, Pi is the integral time. These two together can be made equivalent to what is called as Ki. If this is made, I will quickly tell about the characteristics. We will go on to the mathematical proof, which is an in-depth aspect that we will take on later. Now going on to the characteristics aspect, this will have characteristics which will be for a, now we are talking about a PI controller. For a PI controller, the characteristics would be time for 1 as a unity input. If you take out the characteristics, for ideal characteristics of the controller with a better tuning, this would be the shape. Considering for Ki to be a very small value, if Ki value is going to be very small, the impact is Kp, let it be the optimal one, this Ti value is going to be very, very large. If Ki value is very small, this response curve will be very sluggish. Meaning, the system will try to balance between sluggishness and sensitivity. Now, going on to the next version, if Ki value is going to be very high, the impact is Ti will be very, very small. If Ti is going to be small, obviously Ki will be very high, the system would be like this. If you could make an observation, I cannot have a system which can have a very high value of Ki or a very low value of Ki. An optimal value is desired, and that optimal value will give me the optimal overshoot as well as the optimal settling time. Ultimately, it is balancing between sensitivity to sluggishness. This is about a PI controller. Now, moving on to the ultimate. What is the ultimate here? okay, if I'm very much interested in reducing the oscillations, then I have to go on for introducing something called as a derivative controller. This derivative controller will have an option. What is the option? M proportional to E plus integral of E dt, then this would be proportional to the derivative of error, which means rate of change of error is also getting into considerations. So in that particular case, if I want to equate this, this will be M will be equal to Kp E plus Kp divided by Ti into integral E dt plus Kp into Td dE by dt. This case we call it as Ki, this will be called as K suffix d. This Kd need not be preferred for level, pressure, flow processes, but it's of very much usefulness in terms of a temperature control. Why? In temperature control, I am not in a position to afford for fluctuations. Therefore, I prefer a derivative controller. Derivative controller is nothing but a one wherein the oscillations would be into a format wherein it will exhibit controlled sluggishness. So the optimal curve for the derivative controller would be the overshoot will be slightly higher than a optimal PI controller, but it would be more control. That is what is the significance. Students, now going on to some methods, the methods would make it tuning. You may ask, is it possible to have an individual I controller or a D controller? The answer is no. It is not possible. It will lead to unstable systems. Is it possible to have a PD controller? Yes, but the offset will be always there. It will never eliminate the offset. Therefore, an ideal controller will be preferred as a PI, and if necessary, then what is the best method? Ziegler-Nichols method would be very much useful for tuning a controller. And how to do Ziegler tuning method? That is another part. Probably we will have to go into a situation to find out the ultimate gain. Then from the ultimate gain, we will try to find out the ultimate period. With these two, we can have some formulae which will help us to get the values. That we can go on to the next session. Have a nice day.